Hi, I am Sergey, and in this video, we are going to fix a failing API test. Again, this video is part of the Debugging Galaxy tutorial. So, fixing an API test. Let me share my screen. Here is the tutorial, and we are on API test failure. So, API tests test various aspects of the Galaxy API. They also test general backend aspects of Galaxy that use the API. They require a Galaxy instance. They are significantly slower than your unit tests, but still they are fairly fast, fast enough to give you a reasonably fast feedback when you are developing. So heading on to the hands-on section, part one, finding the failing test on GitHub. So again, like the unit test, we're going to follow the same process. So why don't we head over to the Galaxy repository on GitHub? So again, make sure you are in Galaxy project galaxy and make sure that you have the training branch selected. Again, if you happen to be on the default branch, which is dev, you will need to click this button, get the drop-down menu, and head all the way to the bottom until you find the training branch. The training branch contains the bugs which have been engineered and added to Galaxy, especially to support this tutorial. So after this, we find the latest commit. It's this one, 02EB and so on. And we click the red X right next to the last commit. In the red X, we find API test slash test 3.7 and so on. Sometimes your screen resolution will only permit API test slash tests test 3 to be displayed. That's fine. This is the one, this is the failing workflow we need to look at. Again, I'm going to right click details, open link a new tab so that I can have this list of all the failures in a separate tab. And this is the tab which has been opened. Again, GitHub very nicely auto scrolls all the way to the bottom, so I don't have to scroll through 4,000 lines. And I get this very scary list of failing tests. So let's head over to the tutorial to make sure we are doing what we're supposed to be doing. So click the same red X, select the API tests, try to find the failed tests. Well, we see quite a few. There are 8 failing tests. Each of these lines, starting with failed, is going to list the specific test that has failed in this workflow. We don't need to look at all of them, actually. So if you open the solution will tell you the 2 tests which you are going to address in this tutorial, in this part of the tutorial. So first of all, the log lists multiple failed tests. Some of them were caused by bugs you'll be fixing in later sections of the tutorial. Bugs are not independent. Tests are not independent. So one bug may cause more than one failure. That's why you see all those additional failures. Sorry for that. You'll just have to ignore the rest. For now, we look at these 2 failures. One is test licenses.py, test 404 or unknown license. And the other one is in the same test module, test licenses.py. And the test function is test get license. So this is the one we're going to address, and this is the one we're going to use to fix this bug. Part 2, running the tests locally. Again, we will run the individual tests locally. You don't want to wait for feedback from running these tests remotely, which will come possibly in a few hours. This is not what you need. You need quick feedback. So while it is possible to run the test directly with PyTest, in this case, we will use Galaxy's test running script, runtest.sh. The script optimizes test runs by sharing the same instance of Galaxy across multiple tests. Without the script, a new Galaxy will be started for each test case class. there are other reasons to run this script. And for more information, you can take a look at the documentation block at the top of that script. And let me show you that script. So heading over to my tutorial, this is my Galaxy root. And if you look at the files, you will see runtests.sh. So if we look at that file, you will see that the top of that file has a long section, which is detailed documentation about how to run this script and how this script is going to help you run specific tests, not the entire test suite. Although, of course, you can just use runtests.sh and it will run all the tests which it can discover, and that'll be a lot. Back to the tutorial. So once again, we can use PyTest and then specify the path to the test. We will use runtest.sh script to get you into a habit of using that script for API tests. Would that make a difference for this particular case? No. But when you are running multiple tests, absolutely yes. You don't want Galaxy to be recreated for every single test. So without further ado, let's go ahead and run the failing tests, which is located in lib galaxy test api test licenses.py. So pay attention, the unit tests were located in test slash and so on and so forth. The API tests are located in lib slash galaxy test and so on. So run test.sh dash API and the test. Run tests dash API lib galaxy test API. And what was it? Test licenses. And run. Holding fingers crossed. If you are running this for the first time on your machine, this may take a long time, but subsequent runs will be fairly fast. So you see test session has started. It has discovered three tests, or rather it has collected three tests, and it is running them. Excellent. Two failed, one passed. And we have the same tests failing that we were interested in. So let's head back to the tutorial and see what steps we need to take. Two tests are failing. Do you see the error messages? Solution, yes, we see the following error messages. Let's check the terminal. Yes, here they are. Failed, lib galaxy test, API test licenses.py. And that points to the specific test function. And the second one is the same thing, just a different test function. The error messages are assertion error, request status code 500, which is a server error, was not expected value 404, body was invalid. It doesn't really matter what exactly the error message says. What matters is that we see a 500 error and a 404 error. Back to the tutorial. So this means that instead of HTTP status code 200, well, we get an error status. Again, sometimes multiple test failures may be caused by the same error, and this is the case here. So we're going to try to find this error, fix it, and hopefully, fingers crossed, this will fix both of these tests. Heading to part three, finding and fixing the issue. So in this case, we can use either one of these tests to start debugging. Let's use test get license. As with the unit test, first let's take a look at the test function definition located in lib galaxy test API test licenses.py. It's in fact the same. Well, we know where it's located because that's the command we executed when we ran it. So instead of run test, we are going to launch a text editor pointing to the module with the test function definition. And it's a very small one, which is very nice. it simplifies things. So test get license, I believe this is the one which failed. This is the second function, test function definition. Back to the tutorial. As with this unit test, first let's take a look at the test function definition. So test get license, and here it is, test get license. Let's see what the tutorial says about this. The important line is the third line. So response equals self underscore get, and it points to this string, which it passes it this string as an argument, and the string is in fact an endpoint. So the test tells us exactly what API endpoint is called. Therefore, our next step is to examine the controller for this endpoint. All the controller, or rather for now, almost all of the controllers for endpoints are located in lib galaxy web apps galaxy API, and we need the licenses module. How do we know that? Well, because licenses is part of the endpoint, and in most cases this would be a separate controller. So back to the terminal, we are going to actually, let's open it side by side so we don't have to check what was the function name. So we head to lib galaxy web apps galaxy API, and these are all the controllers. So there is an annotations controller, authenticate controller, and so on and so forth. So we need the licenses controller. So licenses.py. And here it is. Back to the tutorial. There are two controllers. One is a legacy controller, one is an fast API controller. They have identical functionality. We can use either one. We're going to use the fast API controller because, well, the legacy controller will eventually go away. The fast API controller is here to stay. So let's take a look at the fast API controller. And in fact, I believe we don't need the file on the left anymore. Let's just double check. Yes, so we can close it. So here is our controller. Once again, there are two identical controllers, fast API licenses on line 29, this one, and licenses controller on line 48, this one. We are going to work with the fast API licenses. So we have two methods here. One is the top one, which addresses the, which serves the API licenses endpoint. The other one serves the API slash licenses slash ID or license ID, which is the license, specific license identifier variable. So the other one serves this endpoint, and this is the one we care about. Back to the tutorial. So in the FPI, in the fast API controller, you will see the get method that is responsible for fetching the data in response to a get HTTP request received at the licenses slash license identifier endpoint. Let's see where that get method is. So here, this is the router.get is the function or the method decorator. We don't care about it in this case. Async def get. This is the actual method which takes care of the endpoint we are debugging. And it contains really just one line. This return self.licenses licenses manager dot get license by ID. This is the line we care about to in order to debug this failure. Back to the tutorial. So the only thing in this method that matters to us is the last line. Why? Because despite all this syntax, the method simply redirects the request to self licenses manager. And if we read the code, we'll quickly see that this variable holds an instance of licenses manager, which if we look at the import statement, is located in libgalaxy-managers-licenses.py, which is where we should look next. So let's take a look at the code and make sure this syncs in. So I am on line 42, which is an excellent number for a line, and going to line 45, return self licenses manager get licenses by ID. So I'm calling the get licenses by ID method of licenses manager. What is licenses manager? Let's take a look. It is defined on line 30. Licenses manager is of type licenses manager. So what is licenses manager with the L and M capitalized? Let's take a look at that one. It's defined, well, it's imported at the very top from Galaxy managers licenses import licenses manager. So let's head on to Galaxy managers licenses. Again, let's open this side by side. I'm heading to lib Galaxy, enter key problems. Once again, let's try again. Lib Galaxy managers licenses, here it is. And this is where the licenses manager is defined. And if I look for it, it's right here on line 101. Now in licenses manager, I need a method get licenses by ID. This one, and it's defined right here at the very bottom of licenses manager. So I'm going to close the left side of the screen so it gets out of the way. And I am left with licenses manager. So get license by ID. Once again, what is this? This is the method which is invoked from the controller, from the API controller, which services the API endpoint, which indicates an API test failure. So something bad is happening with this method. Back to the tutorial. We carefully trace the code in licenses manager, we'll find the error. Do you see it? Let's take a look at the code. So get license by ID takes identifier, which is a string, as an argument. And let's see, we call the get method of the licenses manager, and that get method will get us something, and that something is assigned to variable named license. Next line, 130, if license.get license ID is none, and none is the default value, then we raise an exception. We raise the object not found exception, which causes the 405 error. So this happens. So line 131 happens. Line 132 does not happen, because then we would get the expected result and the test would not fail. We would get HTTP code, status code 200. So the exception is raised, which means that the if clause, the expression on line 130, if license get so-and-so is none, evaluates to true. So this line is at fault, so it cannot find the license we are looking for. Let's take a look at line 129. This line calls the get method of the license manager, which is defined on line 116, right above, almost above this method. So here it is. Let's head back to the tutorial to make sure we are on the right track. Solution. The get license by ID method raises an object not found error, which results in the 404 status we see in the test result. This error is a direct result of the get method called on the previous line. Take a look at that method. So we're looking at this get method, back to the terminal. So get takes a URI as an argument. If URI not in self by index, return self by index etc., etc., etc. So code can be difficult to read. Galaxy code can be impossible to read. So instead of trying to figure out this, we can simply rewrite this, of course, after looking at checking what exactly is underscore by index, but you will very easily see that by index is in fact a dictionary, and you can find that out by looking at where by index is defined, actually underscore by index, which is on line 111. So here it's an instance variable on the license manager object. So here we go, underscore by index, the value of by index local variable is assigned to it. And what is by index without the underscore? Well, it's defined on line 104, and it's just a by index. Back to our get method. Instead of reading the tutorial and rephrase it, it'll become clear. So the clause, if you are right, not in self by index, return self by index, can be rephrased as if key not in dictionary, return the value stored by that key in that dictionary. And that makes no sense whatsoever. Essentially, you are saying if the key is not in dictionary, then get the value for that key from that dictionary. It should be the opposite. If key is in dictionary, then get the item of that key. So the not after key, this one, is clearly a typo, or obviously, more accurately, a very, very wicked edit made for the purpose of setting up this wonderful learning experience. So let's remove this negation and rerun the test back to the terminal. If you are right, not in self index, if you are right in self by index, write and quit and rerun the test. Hopefully it will pass. Success, we win, we fixed it. Back to the tutorial. So we ran the test, everything worked, congratulations. So again, now commit your edit, don't forget to supply a useful commit message and move on to the client errors. So again, let's see, git status, one file is changed, git add all, git commit, and here you would add a useful message. Let's see, git commit, and the message would be remove negation fix API test. This is probably not the most useful message, not the most useful commit message for this case, but it's, well, good enough. And now you would commit, and now you would push your branch. So once again, congratulations, the API test is fixed, and now you can move on to fixing the client test. Thank you.